Hello friends. In this video, we will talk about a useful device for smart home systems, a Zigbee router, which is designed to ensure interaction between network nodes. It can connect to other Zigbee routers as well as end devices, thereby reducing the load on the central coordinator. This increases the network's coverage area and its capacity, meaning the number of devices that can be connected simultaneously. The use of a standard USB interface and 5-volt power supply allows for easy backup power. In case of a power outage, when other devices such as routers, bulbs, sockets, and relays lose power, battery-powered end devices will switch to this router, maintaining network integrity. More on this later, but for now, as usual, I kindly ask you to like this video, which will help others interested in smart home topics find it, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so already. The device type is a Zigbee 3.0 router. Power connector USB, you can use any charger, or available ports on computers, TVs, and audio systems. I recommend connecting it to uninterruptible power supplies or charging stations. Size excluding connector, 41 by 22 by 11 millimeters. Basic ecosystem, Tuya Smart, Smart Life. The device comes in a very small cardboard box, packed in a shockproof bag by the seller. It arrived in about 2 weeks from the order date. I already have several Zigbee USB routers of a different model, which you can review through the link in the description. This one is much larger and has a cap on the USB connector. The case has a single button for forced pairing mode. To activate it, hold the button until the red LED under the case starts blinking. For comparison, it's about the size of a regular 64GB USB flash drive, though a bit longer. As for the mentioned Zigbee router, functionally, it is the same device. I have three of these, all with autonomous power. When power outages occur and all other routers with stationary power are down, battery-powered end devices connect to them, and the network remains intact. Otherwise, the devices may enter deep sleep mode, from which they need to be manually awakened. The energy consumption of such devices is very low. This measurement was taken during testing, with around 10 devices connected to the router. It can operate on a small UPS with lithium batteries for dozens of hours or even several days. The case is fairly easy to disassemble. It's made up of two halves held together by clips. Inside is the router's board, which is quite compact. The internal antenna is visible on the right. It uses a SoC from Telink, TLSR8258, which is commonly found on various development boards, such as ESP32, C3, and similar. It's a decent and proven controller, although Tuya usually uses its own modules in their ecosystem devices. The marking on the board is ZG807Z, and on this side, you'll find the pairing mode button and the LED. The basic ecosystem is Tuya Smart, so let's start with that. To connect, you need a gateway, which serves as the coordinator or the central hub of the Zigbee network. There can only be one coordinator per network. If you have multiple gateways, each will have its own network. However, you can have many routers and end devices. The device under review enters pairing mode automatically when powered on. If this doesn't happen, you need to press and hold the button on the case until the LED starts blinking. The router will then be detected and connected to the selected gateway. It has its own simple plugin with no special functions. It only displays the status of the gateway and offers basic settings. There is an offline status notification, but it will only appear within 30 minutes of the device being disconnected. You can also check the firmware version, share access, or remove the device from the system. The router doesn't participate in automations. It operates on a set it and forget it principle. Zigbee networks are self-organizing, and other devices will decide when to connect to it on their own. In Google Home and HomeKit, the router is not visible, and it's not necessary there since it functions independently within the Zigbee network. In the standard home assistant integration with Tuya, it appears as an unsupported device. So let's move on to Sonoff iHost, a local smart home control center, with links to videos about it in the description. The firmware version at the time of testing is 2.2.0. It has its own Zigbee coordinator, allowing devices to connect directly. As seen from my reviews and tests, It supports not only EWE Link ecosystem devices, but also Tuya, Acura, and possibly others. The router is displayed as a Sonoff Zigbee micro USB relay, with a link to its review in the description. Its tile indicates that it functions as a signal repeater. Here's what its internal plugin looks like. There are no additional options, and the router works entirely on its own. In the device information, you can view its model, ID, manufacturer code, and remove it from the system. Next, we check it in the default Home Assistant integration for Zigbee devices, ZHA. Here, I use a USB coordinator based on the EFR32MG21 with SkyConnect firmware, with a review link, as usual, in the description. Let's proceed with the connection. Incidentally, if the router is disconnected from the coordinator and powered at the same time, it automatically enters pairing mode. This is convenient because you don't need physical access to the device. In ZHA, the router is supported, but the only available object is the identification button. I expected the LED to blink when pressed, but it didn't. There was no response. You can also view connection information and the device type. Like in the previously discussed cases, the router operates autonomously. Forcing it to connect new devices isn't possible. However, the situation is slightly different in the next system. Of course, we're talking about Zigbee 2 MQTT, which, in my opinion, is the most advanced system for working with Zigbee devices today, especially in conjunction with Home Assistant. The version used at the time of testing is 1.40.1. The router connected without any issues, and it's natively supported, so there's no need to add external converters. It appears as the compact version. I compared it with earlier in the video. The model number is the same, but the manufacturer codes are different, which is normal for the Tuya ecosystem. As with other systems, there are no additional objects here, only signal quality levels. However, that's all a router really needs. What's more important is in the top right corner, where you'll find the button for enabling pairing mode. By default, it's set to allow discovery, all. There's a drop-down menu next to it. By clicking on it, you can manually specify what to connect to. This includes the coordinator and all the routers connected to it. This is particularly useful when a device being connected is far from the coordinator but close to one of the routers. In such cases, you can choose to connect specifically to that router. Another scenario where this helps is when a device, for some reason, doesn't want to connect in the general mode. You can try cycling through the available routers, which might resolve the issue. The pairing process is standard and no different from usual, except that the device may later switch to another router or coordinator by itself, which is normal for a Zigbee network. In the network map, you can easily see that the connected socket is currently working through the USB router. If the router is disconnected, the socket will eventually reconnect directly to the coordinator. Aside from expanding the network's coverage, routers also help increase its capacity by offloading some direct device connections from the coordinator. Right now, there's only one connection going to the coordinator, while all others are routed through the USB router. One device has already switched to the socket, which is connected through the router. A frequently asked question is why purchase a separate router if the network already has enough of them, such as outlets, relays, bulbs, and switches with neutral wires. First, for such devices, the router function is secondary. As shown in my router test, link in the description, some models can only connect a few devices. Second, and most importantly, the USB router can easily be backed up with power. In the event of a power outage, when all other routers stop working, it will take over all battery-powered end devices. Otherwise, if they can't find a new route, they will go into deep sleep mode, which you'd have to wake them for manually. That's all for now. I hope the video was useful and interesting to you. I'd appreciate your likes, as they help with YouTube's algorithm. If you don't want to miss new reviews and tutorials, make sure to subscribe to my channel. In the description, you'll find links to stores where you can purchase the devices shown in the review, links to other videos on this topic, and links to my Telegram channel, Facebook page, and Smart Home Discussion Group. Join us, it'll be fun. Thanks for watching, see you next time, and peace to everyone.